Hello everyone, welcome back to another episode of Let's Play Kingdom Hearts. I made my way to Merlin's house through the underground tunnel and the secret passage. And on the way I killed just like a few Heartless right before the entrance to the tunnel, and my Sora actually gained a level. So he also got an extra accessory slot. So what I did was I took the Ray of Light from Goofy and I gave it to Sora. And then I gave Goofy an extra energy bangle that I was holding on to. But anyway, today we're going to be doing Winnie the Pooh, because I got a few torn pages, and it's been a while since we've been here. We could leave this till the end, but we're here now, and doing this gives us items anyway, so why not? So I like to do this minigame first, because it's actually my favorite out of all the minigames. It's also the most annoying. Then again, actually, all the mini-games in Winnie the Pooh's book are really annoying, but they have to be done, and with a certain record, if you want to get a 100% on the end of the game, if I'm not mistaken. Anyway, so if you notice, if you pick plants from Rabbit's Patch on the outside here, sometimes you have a chance of finding an item. Nothing big, maybe a potion. I don't think there's anything else that it might drop besides that. Maybe others, but I doubt that. I barely found a potion. Anyway, so on the back of Rabbit's house, we can find Pooh and Piglet, and, well, they're looking for Rabbit, and it seems like nobody's home. But who's nobody if nobody's answering? Someone must be home! But before going inside, let's look around a little bit. See any mail? Yes. Yes, we will be having much honey today, Pooh. Much honey indeed. And just like me, Pooh's curious as to who exactly nobody is, and if whether or not he's seen Rabbit. So Pooh climbs in, like classic Pooh, and lo and behold, we find the rabbit! The culprit of the honey! Something. Or other, I don't know. I love Winnie the Pooh. I love Pooh stories, by the way. I don't know if I've ever told you guys this, but like, Pooh is one of my favorite Disney characters. Like, I never really read it a lot as a kid. I used to watch the cartoon on Disney when I was really young. And, I mean, I never really appreciated Winnie the Pooh, though, as a character until I got older. You know, and I realized how much he, like, how much of a figure he is in the Disney world, and just so he's so innocent, you know, and just so charming as a character. I really do love Winnie the Pooh. And, I mean, you guys have probably heard me say this before in my other videos, but, I mean, who can't love Winnie the Pooh? Look at him! He's so happy and fat, and he just loves honey so much, and you just want to love him. Anyway, so the reason we're here is to find Pooh honey, because as everyone knows, Pooh is a boss, and if you don't give the Pooh boss, the bear boss, some honey, you know, I mean, he's just gonna go, you know, bear on you. I don't even know what that means. I'm sorry. Anyway, so we find Pooh his honey here in Rabbit's house, and to be honest, at this point, I actually forgot what I needed to do. I kind of talked to everyone, and I ran outside, and I remember there was a scene that was supposed to play out here, in the back of my head. I'm thinking to myself, okay, like, what do I need to do next? That can't be it, right? I know there's a mini game here, so like I said, I kind of got confused here. So I came back inside and talked to all of them, and I was just kind of like, guys, minigame? Yes, no, what's going on? So I figured, okay, well, maybe I need to leave and come back. So on the way out is when the actual minigame slash cutscene that I was thinking of occurs. So on the way out, Pooh also tries to leave, but silly Pooh, he tries to leave the way he came in, and he doesn't realize after he eats that, you know, he gets bigger, as all people do. Well, people and Pooh Bears, apparently. So we need to help him out, but how can we do this? I have no idea, personally. Well, Rabbit does, apparently. We need to get him some carrot juice. I'm not mistaken. I think he mentions this in a little bit, so maybe I should have said that. Anyway, either way, it doesn't really matter. But, yeah, we come outside to check on Pooh, and we're like, yo, bro, what you doing? And, he's stuck. I mean, you know, there's no way he's gonna get unstuck. Except for carrot juice, which apparently can help you slim down. If that were true, I would, you know, probably buy tons of carrot juice and slim myself down. Because I'm a little bit of a tubby pear? No, I'm a pear. I'm a little bit of a tubby poo type person myself, you know? It's all good, though.
Hey there! Name's Tigger! T-I-Double-Guhh-RR. That spells Tigger! Well now, I don't think I've ever seen you before.
Hello, Tigger. You've just bounced my new friend, Sora.
Hey, Pooh! Say, you're looking mighty uncomfy today. Is that some new exercise? Why, bouncing around is a lot more fun!
Well, why do you bounce around so much, Tigger?
Why? 'Cause bouncing's what Tiggers do best! Speaking of which, my bouncing spot has gone and disappeared! So for now, this will be my new bouncing ground!
And so enters Tigger, T-I-Double-Guhh-RR. Everyone's favorite Winnie the Pooh character. My two favorite are actually Pooh and Eeyore. Tigger was a close third. But yeah, I love Tigger. And I love all the Pooh characters, really, but Eeyore and Pooh are my absolute favorites. So, Owl here is explaining the minigame. Basically, the premise of the minigame is that Tigger wants the mounts, and he just so happens to be bouncing on the carrots that you need to make the carrot juice. Well, we can't have this, so basically, we need to stop him from bouncing on the carrots by, well, blocking him. So, if that makes any sense, we need to run under him and block him from bouncing on top of the carrots. And we also get a command called Rush. Basically, it makes Sora, like, run really fast to the spot where Tigger's going to land, but to be honest, it's not a really good command to rely on for this minigame. You can use it, but when it comes down to it, you're going to manually have to face Sora to the way that Tigger is going to bounce. As you can see, just using Rush alone is not enough. If you use it in combination with turning, then it works, but it's a little bit hard. Sometimes it's just easier to actually move to him. Of course, if he's bouncing like that far, it's a little hard to do that. Yeah, and Sora is a little bit touchy on the controls as well. So this game, when I said it was my favorite game, it's my favorite because it's the simplest game, but it's also really annoying because of how touchy Sora can be. And then, of course, sometimes Tigger just derps up and tries to bounce on the same spot over and over again. But anyway, the score that you have to get here in order to get a new record, or the, like, high record or whatever in your book, is over 150. So I'm going to try and do it here the first time, but chances are I'm probably not going to get it. I don't remember what my score was. Yeah, 143. Yeah, it was pretty close. I'll just get it at the beginning of the next episode.
Especially for a non-Tigger. Let's have another go.
There's actually a different cutscene for how well or poorly you do on this minigame, so I think that's pretty interesting. You'll see a different cutscene next time when I get the over 150 score. So yeah, anyway, now that we've protected the carrot patch, we get to make some carrot juice and help Pooh get out. So now that Pooh has the juice, it's time to heave-ho.
Bother. Where am I? It's ever so dark in here. Well, it isn't so bad, I suppose. There is plenty of honey.